Hi again, everyone. As I mentioned in my introduction, we're going to have a Q&A now. And so my co-programmer, Amir Husak, and I will introduce our guests. I will say something about Alen Drljević, the director of Men Don't Cry. He's a graduate of the Academy of Performing Arts in Sarajevo. And his 2005 short film, The Paycheck, was nominated for a European Award for Best Short. His 2006 documentary, Carnival, explored the effects of the conflicts of the 1990s on the former Yugoslav states. After working as an assistant director on three films with director Jasmila Žbanić, who we know well, Alen embarked on his own career as a feature director with this debut, the critically acclaimed Men Don't Cry. And by the way, maybe you noticed this in the opening credits, Jasmila Žbanić is one of the producers of the film. Amir is going to say something about Emir Hadžihafizbegović. And maybe you should mention the awards that the film got as well.
Sure, yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. Good evening, everyone. My name is Emir Husak, and together with Diana, I'm one of the this year's festival programmers. I have the honor and privilege also to introduce Emir Hadžihafizbegović, who is one of the most prominent Bosnian film, theater, and television actors. He has appeared in over 50 films, many of them critically acclaimed and award-winning features, most notably in the Golden Palm winning When Father Was Away on Business in 1985, then a Golden Bear winning Grubavica in 2006, Remake in 2003, Fuse in 2003 as well, Death of a Man in the Balkans in 2012, These Are the Rules in 2014, and so on and so on. The list is really long. He's also known for his recurring roles on television series Visa za budućnost, or Visa for the Future, Naša Mala Klinika, Our Little Clinic, and Lutz Bunjan Normalan. Originally an aspiring sports reporter, Hadžihafizbegović, who was born in Tuzla, moved to Sarajevo and entered the Academy of Fine Arts of Sarajevo in 1982, receiving his diploma in 1986. And I should also remind you that Hadžihafizbegović is twice nominated for the BHFF 2018 Jury Award for Best Acting Performance in Men Don't Cry, and also another film, The Frog, which is in the program tomorrow. So I would also add that the film hasn't been out more than a year, less than a year, definitely, and it has already won several awards at Carlo Vivari International Film Festival, Special Jury Award, and Europa Cinemas Label Award, then Gothenburg Film Festival, Bratislava Best Fiction Film Award, and Zagreb FF Golden Pram Award for Best Feature Film, and so on. So please join me in welcoming both Alen and Emir to the stage.
Good evening to both of you, and thank you so much for being our guest at this year's festival. It's truly an honor. So we're going to start with a question for Alen, I believe, yes?
Yes, yes, welcome. And first question is, I like to ask this question always, specifically at the Bosnian Film Festival. Is this your first time in New York?
Yeah, that's my first time in New York, and thank you for coming, and thank you for inviting us.
Absolutely, such a pleasure to have you here. This your first
prvi put
time?
Na festivalu, a prvo dobro večer svima.
Good evening, first.
Hvala vam što ste izdvojili svoje dragocjeno vrijeme da dođete da pogledate naš film.
Thank you for taking out some of your precious time to come and see this film.
U New Yorku sam treći, četvrti put, ali prvi put na festivalu. Hvala organizatorima na pozivu. Hvala vam što organizujete ovaj festival, doktoru Harbi i svim ljudima koji su dugo oko festivala. Ovo je značajna stvar za bosansko-hercegovačku kinematografiju.
This is my third or fourth time at, in New York, but first time at a film festival. And he's he wants to thank the organizers of the festival, especially Dr. Harba, the founder of the festival, for creating this endeavor, because it's really important for our culture.
So, Alen, if I remember correctly, you originally started researching for this film. You actually originally wanted to make a documentary, and you have attended some of these workshops, right, in your research. Can you tell us a little bit more about this process and what ultimately made you decide to make a feature narrative instead of a documentary, and maybe tell us about the process of actually being present at some of these workshops?
Yeah, when I've heard, the film is based on the true events, true workshops for war veterans from Serbia, Croatia, and Bosnia. And when I heard about these workshops, it was a very interesting subject for me. And my idea was to make a documentary, to make research for eventually making documentary. And I went to one of these workshops. I went there as a participant because I also was a soldier in the army, in the Bosnian army, during the war. And I was young at time during the war, and for me it was a closed chapter. And I went there basically to make research for documentary, but. When I came to this workshop, it was really something strange happened. Then I realized actually how many unsolved things about the war I have in myself, and it was really something. Something what started with the tension, sitting with the people, with the former enemies, and the talking about that, and then it came to some kind of empathy, and it was really cathartic in a way for me. I forgot totally about film, about everything, about the reasons I came, and long after that, I realized, talking with my producers, we realized it's a very good, very important subject for us. And there were two reasons to decide to make to start with a script for feature film. First one, I realized it's really really tough thing to come with the camera to this workshop, because it's really hard for these people there to open themselves in front of the former enemy. And it would be, I think, impossible in presence of cameras. And the second reason was we realized it's actually it was important for us in Bosnia, in the region, this subject. And we realized that documentaries, there is no much audience at documentary screenings. I can't remember the last documentary film in distribution in Bosnia and Herzegovina. So we wanted more audience to see the movie. So that's how it started.
To specifically really reach a larger audience for that, one of the reasons was.
So I have a question for Emir, you'll translate. So my question for you is, this is such an ensemble-based film that really doesn't have one main protagonist, but many of them. And each of the actors gets their moment to shine in different scenes, but then at other times kind of take the back seat to other characters. So I was really interested in the process of collaborating with your fellow actors in creating each of these individual characters in such a kind of limited amount of space and still fully fleshing them out. And did you have rehearsals? What was the process like?
Prije nego odgovorim na pitanje, zahvalio bih se i gospodinu Pozdercu, direktoru festivala Damiru, koji je korespondirao s nama i vrlo je pokazao senzibiliranost na to da svi dođemo na festival.
Before I answer this question, I would also like to thank the director of the festival, Damir Puzderec, who really showed an initiative in actually getting us also here.
Ovako, znate, svi vaši gosti ovde u Njorku su prošli rat i agresiju na Bosnu i Hercegovinu.
All of your guests here at the Bosnian and Herzegovinian Film Festival here in New York have gone through the war and this aggression on Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Nas dvojica smo bili pripadnici armije Bosne i Hercegovine.
We both were members of the army of Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Elmir Jukić, koji je ovde, koji je reditelj sutrašnjeg filma Žaba, je bio u armiji Bosne i Hercegovine.
Elmir Jukić, the director of The Frog, the film that is playing tomorrow, was also a member of the army.
Bila cijeli rat, Aida Begić bila u Sarajevu.
Aida Begić spent the war years also in Sarajevo, the director of the film.
Ademir Kenović cijeli rat bio u Sarajevu.
Ademir Kenović, the producer of the film that is screening
Monci
tomorrow also.
Iz filma Iron Maiden su bili cijeli rat u Sarajevu. Mm-hmm. Dakle, ekipa iz filma Screen for Me.
The crew and the makers of the film Scream for Me Sarajevo, which is playing tomorrow, have also been doing the
Rijetko se kad desi glumcu u njegovoj karijeri da se iluzija, a film je iluzija i stvarni život tako surovo sudare pred kamerom.
It's really rare that for an actor also that a real life and this fiction kind of collide in such a way in front of a camera.
Drugačije igrati kralja Lira, drugačije igrati Čehovljeve junake, drugačije igrati Gogoljeve junake, antičku dramu i Aristofana, a drugačije igrati pred kamerom ono što je napisano kao scenario, a vi ste to zapravo prošli i to još možda u ekstremnijem obliku nego je to priča na filmu.
It's different to play King Lear or to play in an antic drama or any of these than to play in something where the script is such that it really reflects your own experiences or it's even worse than what you have experienced yourself.
Orwell i njegova 84. Su eufemizam za ono što smo mi doživjeli u Bosni.
Orwell's 1984 is almost a euphemism for what we've gone through in Bosnia.
Ali ono što je meni drago, ovo je jedna snažna antiratna poruka. I ovo je jedan antiratni film.
What pleases me is really that this is a strong anti-war film with a strong anti-war message.
Ono što mi je takođe drago jeste da ovaj film funkcionira na svim meridijanima.
Also what I find good is that this kind of film also is kind of functions universally and can be understood also in a wider context. Jel, so to say.
Ingrid Bergman u svojoj biografiji kaže da bi nešto bilo univerzalno prije svega mora biti lokalno.
So Ingmar Bergman actually in his biography said that in order for something to be universal, first it has to be local.
Tako da evo završavam proces rada na ovoj ulozi je bio kao i proces rada na svim ulogama koje sam radio, ali je imao tu dodatnu dramaturgiju koja je odmotana u periodu 92-96.
So the process actually was very similar to many other films I've been in, but with this added sort of dramaturgy of something that kind of was spinning off or already in 1995 and 1996.
And I have a question for you, Alen, as well. And I heard you talk about this at the Sarajevo Film Festival as well. It was one of the questions. The film is full of such gut-wrenching moments that are at times really difficult to take. And I'm sure especially for a lot of audience members to whom this is also, the war has been a personal experience. But it's also punctured by humor, a lot of humor. I just wanted you to say something about that. How did the humor enter the fray? Was it always planned? Was it organic? Was it sometimes improvised between the actors? Was it part of your research, something that came up during your research?
Yeah, but actually, whole characters, every character, each character in the movie is made upon the real characters. Some are made upon actors' war biography. For example, Valentin by Leon Lučev is made by his war biography, his character. And there are also some non-professional actors in the movie, real war veterans. So everything came from the real characters, real stories, and also this humor is these bits of humor, something that happened on real workshops, or it came during the other rehearsals. We had first rehearsals 1.5 years before the shooting. We went in the hotel Bistrica at Olympic Mountain Jahorina near Sarajevo, and we spent 3 days there, actors and psychiatrist Vladimir Milošević from Belgrade, now lives in Slovenia. He's one of the pioneers of the psychodrama in ex-Yugoslavia, and he helped us a lot. So we worked a lot, not just on the script, on the scenes from the script, but we worked a lot on ourselves. And actually the real actors and our real life was mixing with the characters from the movies. And we also, after these rehearsals, made a new version, new drafts of scripts. So all the actors are actually the authors of the script. So there were also some improvisations during the shooting, because we wanted to keep something of this documentary approach in the movie.
And if I may just interject, some of the actors or extras, if you will, in the film are actual veterans who have participated in some of these workshops.
Yeah, two of them are real war veterans. They're not actors.
I have a question for you, Emir. If you could translate, please. We have this film, Men Don't Cry, and tomorrow we're screening also another film that specifically deals with the war trauma and veterans, The Frog, which is playing tomorrow. It has been more than 20 years since the end of the war, and it appears now that we're all of a sudden treating the subject more frequently through the language of film. Is the time ripe for it, or is the film the only place where ready for this kinds of conversation?
Naš čuveni pisac Abdullah Sidran napisao jednu rečenicu u kojoj kaže: u Bosni žive ljudi koji misle da su preživjeli rat. Ili u Sarajevu i u Bosni žive ljudi koji misle da su preživjeli rat.
Our famous Bosnian writer Abdullah Sidran has said one sentence in Bosnia, there live people who think that they've survived the war. Or in Sarajevo, there live people who think they've survived the war.
Pitanje koje ste vi postavili nameće se od završetka agresije na Bosnu i Hercegovinu, pa da ove večeras nje noći u Njujorku. Koliko, kako, do kada ćemo se mi unutar kinematografije baviti agresijom? Ja stalno govorim rat pa agresija, zapravo prava riječ je agresija, jer rat je sukob zavađenih strana, a ovo je bila brutalna agresija na jednu suverenu državu.
So the question you've asked tonight is one that we've been struggling with for the last 20 years. It's not a new question. We've been asking it since the end of the war, since the end of aggression. And Emir wanted to add that he thinks that the actual word, the more precise word for this conflict is aggression, not war.
Znate, na to pitanje može se samo dati hipotetičan odgovor. Dok god bude autora koje provocira taj period, dok god bude umjetnika, književnika, reditelja, slikara, kompozitora, koji imaju potrebu za flashbackom na to vrijeme, dotad će i postojati ovakvi film.
We can only give a hypothetical answer to this question. Thank you so much. What a gentleman. Because as long as there are artists, filmmakers, writers, composers, painters who feel the compulsion or feel the need to address this topic is going to be addressed and worked through art.
Znate, kad vam iscure iz kadra najbolji prijatelji pogođeni snajperom metar od vas, kada izgubite roditelje, kada ostanete bez krova nad glavom i kada iz jednog lagodnog života postanete loser kao duhovna kategorija, onda sa takvim oživcima imate pravo da se time bavite do kraja života.
So when your best friend is killed by a sniper, when your parents die or you lose the roof over your head, in other words, when you become a loser in the meaning of a spiritual category, you have every right to tackle this topic and to cope and deal with this topic for the end of your life.
Tako da ja imam želju, recimo, da režiram jedan film koji ima veze sa periodom 92. i 96. Intenzivno radim na tome i razmišljam, kao što imam i želju da režiram jednu komediju koja se dešava na Jadranu.
I think we're getting some exclusive info here. Scoop. I have a desire to direct a film that would take place between 92 and 96, a drama of sorts, but also a comedy that takes place at the Adriatic.
Yeah, on the coast.
On the coast. We hope you bring the films here. Nadam se da ćeš dovesti filmove na festival.
Ako Bog da.
God willing.
Since we have a limited time for this Q&A, it would be nice also to open it to you, because I'm sure there's questions out there.
There should be microphones going around.
There are microphones, so always wait before you ask.
Because we're recording this, so we need to have everyone on the mic.
There's a question up there.
Hi. First of all, congratulations. Thank you so much for creating such a beautiful work of art. Alen, my question is, so in addition to exploring war trauma and how, you know, former soldiers are dealing with that now, there's also this, you definitely delve into this topic of masculinity and how that's been defined in this region, in Bosnia and Eastern Europe. Was that something important to you, to explore masculinity and how that's been defined in our culture, in Bosnian culture?
Well, first, thank you. Yeah, of course, we were talking a lot about that, and, well, the title, Men Don't Cry, is in a way a little bit ironic, playing with that tradition of a man it's not just in Balkan. It's not just in Bosnia. It's not just in Balkan. This tradition is present everywhere, but especially in Balkan. It was always there was always thought that men in our society is supposed to defend his country, his nation, his religion, his pride, his family, and that man actually is not supposed to show his emotions and maybe not to have emotions at all. And well, of course, it's not true, and it's hard to live with this it's very heavy, something very heavy on your back to live with that, because all these people inside are very emotional, wounded people, and I saw a lot of during the researching for the movie, a lot of people, of war veterans, ex-heroes, crying, and so it's something that's a tradition, and in a way, it's for men, it's not a good tradition, and there was also something very interesting to me that one woman in the audience during Sarajevo Film Festival after the screening said that for her it's this movie is a very feministic movie, and I was not thinking about that in that way, but actually she's not far away with that thinking.
Do we have any other hands? I can't really see really well with this light.
Over here.
You can raise your hand, don't worry, we won't trade roles.
Thank you for a wonderful film. I have a question for the director. I'm not from the region, so I come differently, and I'm responding as just an audience member, and I felt the ending was absolutely perfect, but not as an insider, and I wondered if the sports team at the end suggested to you a way of representing another way of channeling aggression without it being as destructive as it can be, or whether I was missing something else, whether or not there was more conflict in the team. So I wonder if you could just say something about how you came to the ending of the film.
Well, it's an open question, really, about the ending, and it could be both. It could be bright future with a new generation, but it could be also that this new generation is a new army in a new war. I wanted to have a ending open, because actually, in reality, it's open. And we don't know really what's the future. So I could not tell you it is or it is not, because. Thank you.
So I have a question for Alen and a question for Emir, who is from my hometown of Tuzla. So Alen, in terms of choosing which stories to tell, because there are so many different stories, I guess, how did you choose these specific stories? And were there stories that you intentionally omitted because they were not necessarily following whatever was the narrative path that you were following with the story? And then I don't know if I should wait with the second question.
Or just ask right away, we'll translate it. Okay. And then they can.
So the question for Emir is, as an actor working on this particular character, how much did it help you face your own nationalist feelings? And did you feel like it was helpful in terms of personal growth and facing your own demons? Or do you feel that it was
just kind of reconfirming the feelings you already had.
So Alen, maybe if you want to...
You think about story for the movie, entire story, or...
No, the stories, the narratives. So, you know, you chose sort of several stories to be told, yeah, because I'm sure you had many, many more, and it would be impossible to put all of them in one film. So how did that work as a process in selecting which stories to tell and then which stories to maybe leave for a different film?
Yeah, it's similar to, I think, almost every process on working on the script. There is a lot of possibilities always, and you cannot tell everything, and it's not good to tell everything. So you choose something, your main line, and actually whole individual stories must go to one main story. And as I told, some of the stories are based on the actors, real actors' war experiences. Some of them are from my experience, and some of them are from stories I've heard in workshops. And so we made some kind of building characters, using all these parts. Also, not just me, my co-writer Zoran Solomon, who helped me a lot with working on this script.
Thank you. And I do want to say that I thought the arc with the truck and destruction of the truck was absolutely brilliant. I thought that particular sort of like taking all that emotion that built up to that point and then destruction of that was just felt very felt good. So.
Oh, thank you.
Kada bih ja morao determinirati sebe kao osobu, pozvao bih u pomoć dvije sentence. Prva je da postoje samo ljudi i neljudi i da su sve ostale podjele lažne.
If I had to determine myself as a person, I would first have to say that maybe there's...
Postoje samo ljudi, ne ljudi, sve ostale podjele su lažne.
That there's only human and non-human and other kind of differentiations are lies.
A druga je religijske provenijencije i kuransko je aje, kaže ko ubije jednog nevinog čovjeka kao da je sve ljude pobio ili ko spasi jednog nevinog čovjeka kao da je sve ljude spasio.
And the second one actually is religious and it comes from Quran and it says that someone who murders an innocent person it equals practically murdering a humanity and if you save one innocent person is also saving humanity.
Ja nisam birao ni šta ću biti rođenjem, ni gdje ću se roditi, ni geografiju na kojoj ću se roditi. Ja sam bosanski musliman i na moj narod je izvršen genocid.
I didn't choose where to be born or what to be. I just happened to be in Bosnia and I consider myself a Bosnian Muslim and against my people, a genocide has been perpetrated.
Ali to ne znači da mi sada, dok sam ovdje u Njujorku, najbolji prijatelj u životu nije Srbin, odnosno jeste Srbin.
But that doesn't mean that while I'm here in New York, still my best friend wouldn't be a Serb. It is a Serb.
Zašto se mi dobro osjećamo u ovom gradu, bar ja, po ko zna koji put? Pa zato upravo što u ovom gradu u kojem vi živite postoje samo ljudi, ne ljudi, sve ostale podjele su lažne.
And why do we feel so good in this city, in this particular city? It's maybe because of that thing that I said earlier, that all differentiations are a lie except for the one that you divide people on human and non-human.
Dakle, što se tiče identiteta, ovaj film niti je zaljuljao neke moje stavove o identitetu, niti je promijenio. Dakle, Bosna i Hercegovina je bila, a i sada jeste, zemlja sa takvom vrstom multikulturalnosti koja je sačuvana, koja ovaj unezvjereni svijet koji je doveden pred zid, koja tom unezvjerenom svijetu koji je doveden pred zid sa krizom autoriteta, sa neoliberalnim kapitalizmom, dehumaniziranim ambijentom, može biti samo primjer. I kada bi se Bog dom ugledali na Bosnu i Hercegovinu, svijet bi pronašao tu eureku kako dalje.
And in terms of identity, this film did not really make me change much about how I feel about anything, specifically because Bosnia was a multicultural place, and that's to a certain extent also preserved. And if we look at what's happening in general, and specifically developing neoliberal capitalism, dehumanization, etc., Bosnia would actually be a shining example.
Ovi ljudi koji ste gledali na platnu, koji su se gledali preko nišana, jel, u realnom životu u Bosni i Hercegovini spremni su da se dogovore o nečemu dobrom i lijepom unutar Bosne prije nego politika.
And the people that you've seen here on the screen are the ones who are more prepared and ready to find and negotiate solutions than the politicians that we have to actually deal with.
Evo sad jedne groteske, ovaj, koju vjerovatno većina vas zna. Dakle, nakon takvog surovog sukoba, Bosna i Hercegovina od potpisivanja Daytona ima zajedničku armiju. A nema, ne znam, neke druge institucije. Znači, postoji armija Bosne i Hercegovine, na amblemu armije su Ljiljani, koji su bili znakovi armije Bosne i Hercegovine, 4S i Šahovnica. Ta armija jako dobro funkcionira i to je institucija u kojoj se poslije Daytona nije desilo niti jedan incident. To je armija koja ima svoje snage u Iraku, u Afganistanu, koja radi vježbe sa NATO paktom i ta stvar funkcionira besprijekorno. Pogledajte tu grotesku, pogledajte tu jednu, kako bih rekao, inverziju unutar jedne rovite političke situacije u Bosni, da armija Bosne i Hercegovine, koja broji, ja mislim, nekih 11.000 vojnika, uredno se postrojava, sve nacionalnosti su unutra, znakovi koji su bili jedni naspram drugi, sad su zajedno na ramenu tih vojnika i stvar je potpuno legitimna, sjajno funkcionira i nije nikakva konstrukcija, nije nikakva laž, nije nikakva farsična priča, nego zaista ta stvar jako dobro funkcionira.
So it's almost a, if you look at it, it's almost a grotesque, an inversion of sorts, because in Bosnia there is an army which is a unified army. Many other things in the country are actually divided, various institutions are divided between two entities, but then you have an army of Bosnia and Herzegovina that on their insignia carries the signs of all three ethnicities or major ethnicities in the country, and it functions perfectly well. The army is also deployed within NATO in Afghanistan, in Iraq, in many other countries, and it is quite bizarre, actually, if we can actually say kind of the
I think on that note, I think we're out of time, actually. The theater is going to lock us out if we don't clear out soon. Thank you all so much. Let's give our guests a round of applause.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And please don't forget to cast your ballot for the audience award. Right?
Yeah, don't forget to vote. You have your little... If you don't,
and see you tomorrow. Yeah.
Yes, and see you tomorrow at the festival.
Super. Dobro. Hvala puno.